Switzerland is the country in Eurovision who won the first contest and had to wait 32 years before Celine Dion gave the country their second victory. Since then, there hasn't been much in terms of success, apart from some exceptions that we can count on one hand. And in 1998, the worst result of them all happened. 0 points and a witch hunt for the singer Gunvor from the journalist followed. And to be honest, it had already begun. Today, Gunvor has left those scandalous years behind and instead leads a quiet family life in a small village. But she still tells us about her participation in Eurovision, her singing career and new projects. You are listening to Eurovision Legend with your own Null Poix, Emil Löfström. Welcome to Eurovision Legends, Gunvor Meyer.
Hello, nice to meet you. Thank you.
Lovely to have you here.
To having me here.
How are you today?
Yes, great. We have beautiful weather here in Switzerland. We have 27 degrees. We are on the lake. Soon we are going fishing with my son. He's 6 years old and we have holidays.
Ah, great.
Yes, it's great.
First of all, I'm so grateful that you wish to take part and talk to me about your memories and experiences from Birmingham.
Yeah, thank you.
I've had many guests in this podcast and their Eurovision experiences have been both good and bad. But I believe your Eurovision experience must have been one of the toughest that has ever been.
Yeah, it was for me the greatest experience, even though if I had no points, but it was really amazing to be a part of it. And I was 23 when I participated for Switzerland. It was in Birmingham and it was really great. The hall was so big and the stage was huge. And the spectators were great. And we had 1 week time to rehearse and to meet the people with journalists. We had interviews or there were a lot of parties and it was really fun. A holy week with a lot of fun. A whole
great.
Week. Yeah, it was great.
My impression is that you were treated very cynically by many people, such as managers and advisors, but not least certain newspapers who have tried to put you in a bad light just to sell papers.
Yes, it was a funny time in a way. But never mind, it was for me the greatest experience and a big honor to represent my country in Birmingham. It was ever my wish and I couldn't believe that when Switzerland voted me or my song Lassine. That was really fantastic and I had my sister on board on stage and it was really very, very great. These 3 minutes we will never forget.
Ah, beautiful. I have prepared some quick questions. Are you
good?
Ready?
Yes, I am.
First memory from watching the Eurovision Song Contest?
I think I was 4 or 5. We always were watching the Eurovision Song Contest with the family or we invited friends. And even now, not with Corona, but before, we had always guests or friends here and made a special... like a lottery and said, well, now we give points to all countries. And yeah, it was always fun.
Best song from Switzerland in Eurovision, besides Lassine?
I like many songs. This one from Luca Hani. You Got Me, or Celine Dion's song was great. Ne partez pas sans moi. Ne partez pas sans moi. Laissez-moi vous suivre. Vous qui volez vers d'autres villes, laissez-moi vivre. Daniela Simons had also Pas pour moi. Lot of songs. Peter, Sue and Mark, for example, they won twice, I think, for Switzerland.
Darling, I believe 4 times.
Oh, so, wow. Yeah, we had a lot of good songs.
Least favorite song from Switzerland in Eurovision?
Oh, that's a hard question.
You can say pass.
Yeah, I have to pass because I don't know.
Who should have won Eurovision but didn't?
Me.
Love it. I love it. Who should not have won Eurovision but did?
Oh, that's also difficult because it's such, it's a taste of the people. And I'm glad that now the judges are here, are back again. So, that's the best result for the artists or for the song, I think. It's more serious. The competition, it's not more the fun competition, so it's really the song who is who gets the points, and that's for me best. I think it's better now when you have the judges and the TV, so it's 50%, you know. And when I was, there was only the spectators.
Exactly. Yeah.
So you saw that Guildo Horn, he was very funny. He had a lot of points. And I was not that funny. But now I'm, since 3 or 4 years, I'm also in the jury. And I can vote, and I make internet voting for the songs. And that's good. I think it's better. So you really listen to the songs. You don't see the person on stage because you are listening to the song and the voice who is important for a song.
If you could decide, which artist would you send to represent Switzerland in Eurovision next year?
Lady Gaga.
Gaga for Switzerland?
Yes.
Whew. Sounds marvelous. I didn't see that coming, but I love your suggestion.
A lot of points.
Who got your vote in this year's final in Eurovision?
Switzerland, but I couldn't, of course, I couldn't vote. But I think he was great.
Yeah.
And Holland, the Netherlands. Sweden, like every year. Croatia, I guess. Yes. TikTok, watch the days go. I'm losing track of time lost in your play zone. Don't overcomplicate now. We're in war zone. You're screaming. Oh no, oh no, oh no. But especially Sweden, Switzerland, which I couldn't vote. I like those songs very much.
Last quickie. Favorite country in Eurovision besides Switzerland?
Sweden, as I said, Great Britain, Austria sometimes. They also have good musicians. And Australia is not bad as well. France sometimes, and Italy.
Do you always watch Eurovision?
Yes, since I'm 4.
I love even more now, Gunvor. we take it from the beginning. Mm-hmm. In 1997, you took part in the Swiss pre-selection for Eurovision, 1998.
Right.
Held at the DRS TV studios in Zurich, mm-hmm. with a song titled La Zine.
Yes.
The song was composed by Egon Egemann, mm-hmm. and with lyrics written by you.
Mm-hmm. Yes, that's right.
And Egon Egemann competed solo back in Eurovision 1990 with the song Musik klingt in die Welt hinaus.
Yes.
Musik klingt in die Welt hinaus. Musik, die meine Geige spielt. Musik hört man in jedem Haus. Musik, die jeder fühlt.
How did you get in contact with Egon?
In fact, it was my manager who knew him already.
Yeah?
And he was on several shows with him, and that's why he asked him if he could do a song for me or with me.
Yeah.
Yes, that's why we get in contact with Egon, and we like the violin, and yes, that's why we get in touch with him.
How did he present the song?
Uh-huh. Well, it was maybe in October 97.
Yeah.
And I thought it was a great song, and so I made some lyrics for it.
Cocktails, serviert jeden Abend, verzaubert jede Frau, spielt mit seinem Schatz. Ach du, lässt dich von ihm blenden, wachst schon nach einer Stunde.
And I also sent three other songs, one with Peter Reber from Petersu and Mark, and two French songs. But the television took the La Zine song from Egon Egemann and me, and so we got into this election of the six finalists for Switzerland. And then I got elected from the Swiss spectators.
What happened with the rejected songs?
Well,
did you release them?
Only one I released, yes. That's called For Real. It's for my mom. In fact, and every Mother's Day, I post a video again. So every year you can see it, or you can listen to it on YouTube or iTunes and so on.
Love is for real if you have a little baby. Love is forever if you have a child. A little kiss and a smile. Love will follow, and your love will get so sweet. Love is for real, and the childhood will start now. All your love that you've given to me, Mom, thanks to you for all great things you've ever shown. Never forget what you've given to me. Love is for real if you adore someone.
And the other two songs you never released?
No.
Was this the first time you submitted anything to the pre-selection, or had you sung on songs that got submitted before?
No. Okay. It was the first time, and I was very surprised, yes, because I think there were 200 songs they sent to the television, and it was a big surprise for me, and a big dream, of course, because I was always watching it, and it was always the biggest dream, and I never thought that I would get it one day, this chance.
What are your memories from the pre-selection held in December 1997 in Zurich?
It was very, very nice show. Sandra Studer was the representer of the show.
Yes, and she competed in 1991 for Switzerland with Canzone per te.
Right. I think she was fifth on the Eurovision Song Contest.
Exactly. You got skills, Gunvor.
And it was very nice evening. We had a lot of fun, and it was always at the television. It's very professional, and it was really great with my team, and and we were very excited, and we saw the votes, and we were very nervous about the votes. I'm never nervous because of the gig, but of the votes.
Okay.
So I could perform in front of 100,000 people. I'm not nervous, but of the votes I am.
I totally get that. And by a margin of 8 points, you won the pre-selection. Were you surprised?
Yes, because there were a lot of other singers who were as good as I. I mean, it's always a taste of song and singer, and I was very happy.
Do you remember which song you thought would win?
Yeah, I thought that the girls talk about, they were the name, they became second, and I they will win, I thought, yes.
So far, everything was good, but suddenly the media began to dig into your past and negative headlines covered the Swiss newspapers. How did this begin and what happened?
Well, I don't know how it or why it began. It's always more sellable, I think, if you have bad news than good news. I mean, you see now we have a lot of water here. I don't know, in Sweden, do you also have a lot of water?
Yeah, absolutely.
So that medias are full of it. And for me, it was the fact that I had a lot of gigs afterwards, even if I had 0 points, and it was very, very cool because I had a musical show. It was called Nokia Musical Night, and I was with Seven Stars on stage, as well with Sandra Studer. We had a big orchestra, 30 people playing musical songs from Andrew Lloyd Webber or Les Miserables. And we did a Switzerland tour, 10 gigs, and then we went. I had really a lot of weddings or other parties and TV events, radio interviews, and it was a really great time. 2 years, and then I went back to the office.
If we go back to time before Eurovision, as I understand it, this was big news in Switzerland with headlines every day.
Mm-hmm.
But it didn't quite have the same impact in the rest of Europe, who were more preoccupied with an Israeli transsexual singer, Dan International, among others. But nevertheless, this must have been really tough on you personally and affected your preparations for Birmingham.
Well, for me, it was always the 3 minutes were very important for me, that I really can take every note, that every word is on the right place, and the choreography was right placed as well on stage, and that my team was behind me. And so that was for me the biggest preparation of it. And I didn't listen on left or on the right, only there was my family and my manager, and that was important for me, that they were behind me.
Yeah, because you had supporters, right?
Yes.
Great.
And also the TV, the chef of the TV was also there, and they supported me very much, yes.
We skipped the negativity. Can you take us back to your memories from Birmingham?
well, we arrived and then we had a warm welcome on stage, and we were, and the team of BBC, it was a very huge organization behind, and every day we had time, maybe for 20 minutes, we were allowed to go on stage. There was a schedule for first maybe Israel, then Spain, whatever. Every country had his timetable.
Yeah.
And so we were every day on the stage, and they were preparing the lights, but you have to, or if you remember, there was no show like now, these days. I mean, that's great now, what they are doing with the light shows behind of the artists. That was, we only had small lights, not all the effects that they have now. But even though it was very professional, and you just have to think about, you are in the middle of a huge, huge stage. Yeah. And the technique, I mean, the equipment is so professional, and the team of BBC, very friendly, and it was really great. And so after your gig, I mean, your rehearsal gig, you have interviews. So they were RTL or German press, the Swiss press, and from Great Britain, whatever. They are all there and are asking you some questions, and you answer them. And then afterwards, you go eating with the team, and you have a sightseeing in Birmingham. Afterwards, after dinner, you go to a party all together, and it was very fun.
Do you remember anything that happened behind the scenes?
Yes, I remember that everyone who participated. Yeah, sorry. And they had a card with the name on it and the photo of the person.
Yeah.
So I met Guildo Horn from Germany for the first time, and he didn't give me the hand to say hello, my name is. See, he took my card and ate on this card. He just bit on it. And that was, it was funny. It was, Guildo Horn.
Did you meet Stefan Raab too?
I beg your pardon?
Did you meet Stefan Raab?
Ah, Stefan Raab, yes, well, yeah. Yes, also, because he was always with him. Yes, but I didn't talk to him. Yeah, he was the big boss, in fact.
Yeah, exactly.
Not touchable.
I remember that the Swedish press wrote about your Swedish name and Swedish ancestor. What can you tell us about your Swedish roots?
Yes, my grandpa came from Göteborg.
Oh, my hometown.
Oh, nice. Yeah, it's lovely. And when he was 5, he went to Salzburg, and from there he came to Switzerland. And my grandmother came from Italy, and they met in Bern, and they got married, and my mom, was here then on Earth. She was born.
Do you speak Swedish?
Oh, no, only good jul, but that's not the time now.
No, that means Merry Christmas.
Yes, right. No, unfortunately, because he was 5, I think he didn't speak very good. He forgot everything, I guess. And no, with us, he only spoke German.
Before the show, I mean, before the contest, you had pretty good odds and were ranked to be among the top 10.
Really?
I actually checked them online yesterday.
Yes, right.
Who did you see as your biggest competitor?
Well, I think we knew that Viva la Diva was a big, big number. Everyone said that, and we knew that. And I think also England was quite good. And Sweden, like every year. And so, yes, it's true. You have a lot of good artists and very good composers.
Yeah, and the Swedish singer in 1998, Jill Jonsson, is still a big singer here in Sweden.
Wow, cool. That's cool.
Today she sings country music.
Ah, nice. Yeah, that's a big community.
Yeah. Did you have any favorites among the other songs?
Malta, I liked very much. I remember she was a nice, very nice woman, very friendly. And the voice was amazing. I love voices. I mean, as a singer, the song need to be sung by someone who can sing.
Yeah,
for me, that's why I love Céline Dion or Lara Fabian. These are for me great, yeah, the great singer, or Lady Gaga.
You said that the Maltese singer Chiara was very friendly. Was everyone friendly to you?
Yes.
Great.
Yes, really very friendly. It was so professional and yeah. Yes, and they helped each other if you had a question. So everyone was helping each other. Great community, like a family.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. On stage, you were talked about dress who some people thought looked like a bra with nipples.
Yes.
And with a dress hanging from the bra.
I heard that also from my husband, yes. Well, in fact, she won this woman who made my dress. She won the biggest bolero trophy in Switzerland of couture.
Ooh.
And yes, and that's why we went to her, and we were glad that she made a dress for me.
Yeah.
And it was maybe it was roses, in fact, on my bra, and not nipples. But
do you still have it?
No, I don't know. No, she had it. She made it for the day, and I gave it back to her.
Okay, so you didn't pay for it?
No.
Okay. What do you think about your outfit today?
Well, today I would go differently. But yeah, it was good in this time, because I wanted to have a dress very long. And I think she made a good job. But
yeah, and we still remember the dress.
Yeah, so that's a good sign.
Israel won with Dan International and the song Diva. The United Kingdom with Imani got second. And Malta ended third with Chiara. Have any opinions about the top three?
Yes, I loved every title, I have to say. It's really fun and great to listen to those songs. For me, of course, Chiara is a great singer. It's amazing how she sings.
Did you meet Dana International?
Phew. Well, I think she rushed over. No, I didn't. I didn't talk to her, but I know that one of my backing singers, he was talking with her.
And you ended last with 0 points. Gunvor, what was that like?
Well, we were looking to each other, and we were laughing, in fact. It was, we had such a good time, and on those special moments, we realized that we have 0 points. We were laughing. It was funny in a way, because I think, I don't know if someone before me, there were already one time 0 points? I don't know.
Yes, actually several times. If
this year were...
Yeah, United Kingdom.
Yes, this year, yes. Mm-hmm. Of course, you are going to a competition because you want to win and you want to do the best for your country. But I think we did a good job, and it's always, like I said, a matter of taste. You like the song or not, and yes, well, and we had no judges. I mean, the jury, the professional, were not in the judge room, I said, like I told you.
Yeah. I believe that it happened 10 times before you in 98, that a country ended with 0 points.
Oh, yeah. 10. Wow.
And the reason that I know this is in exact numbers is because I have read the book Nul Poids, written by Timor for the research to this episode. And he has written a chapter about every song ended with 0 points till 2003.
Oh, wow. Cool. That's cool.
Did you ever record the song Lazine in English or any other languages?
Yes, we did it once, but I'm not sure if that's... somewhere. I think we did it on the single, you know, we had not the CD before, but the single, the record, and there was an English version, Just Leave Him Be, it was called Just Leave Him Be.
But was the version on the promo single then?
No. Yeah, yes, I mean on this single, yes. Not on the promo, but
because
on the
I have the single and it's not there.
Uh-huh.
It's an instrumental version and a song called On My Own.
On My Own, yeah, from Les Miserables.
Yeah, yeah. Exactly.
Or we did... I know that Jeff Turner, he was a country star in Switzerland from Australia. And I knew that he did the lyrics of the song because we were already prepared. if you win, you had to sing it in English. That's why every song had to be done in English as well. And that's why Jeff did a version of it. But I'm not sure if we did it or... But I know that's nowhere you can have it. It's, I don't know, maybe Egon has it. I don't know.
Do you remember the chorus in English?
No, honestly, no.
So you can't sing it for us now?
No, I don't. No, because it was with the storm something. I don't know. I don't remember. Too long ago. That's my excuse. 23 years ago, I think.
Oh, I totally understand. Yeah, sometimes I don't remember what I did yesterday, so I totally get that. I must ask, how did the poor result in Eurovision affect your career?
Well,
I mean, directly afterwards.
As I told you, I had a lot of gigs afterwards because I was really... they wanted me somehow as a singer. And it was great because I had 4 gigs a week.
Yeah.
And radio and TV interviews. And yeah, I could live from my music. And that was good. I mean, that was always the dream.
How did the media treat you after Birmingham? Better or worse?
No, there was a time when they realized that it was not really my fault, and they treated me good again. And it was Paul Rieneker who made the documentary film from me. And that was also, we went back in this huge hall and there was nothing. It was just gray. And that was so amazing, you know, the impression you have, you remembered all those lights, those people, 20,000 people, and then it's empty, nothing, no light, and it was really, strange.
And the documentary we are talking about is Gunvor, Media History. Mm-hmm. I don't know the original title of it.
Yeah, eine Mediengeschichte, it's called.
Okay, I haven't seen it, but you have?
Yes, once. Yeah.
Okay. The follow-up single to Lazine was another song composed by Egon Egemann titled mm-hmm. Money Makes.
Yes.
But that song sadly flopped.
Yes, it was a disco song and we had no time, in fact, to produce it because I had a big concert in Switzerland, in Zurich, at Volkshaus. And that was the point that I had, I had 2 weeks to prepare something, and that was the reason, but it was not the greatest song for it.
Go to the bank, they turn you down. Your back is to the wall, and turn around. You call your friend, you give me a loan, and he says, why?
later on I had big or good composers like Jens Gad from Hollywood, who was working with Enigma or Sandra. And that's why now the radios are playing my songs. That's fantastic now.
Yeah. Is he the composer of the song Land of Fantasy too?
No, that was someone else. That was Peter Robes who wrote those.
The reason I asked is because that's my favorite song from yours.
Yes?
Yeah.
Take me to my fantasy.
Why did your collaboration with Egon end?
Ooh, good question. Well, I was going back to the office and maybe for 2 years, and I went to Basel.
Yeah.
And I had another producer.
Bring back the feelings from the past, burning love when you were last.
It was quite a reason, because I had other possibility to do my own music that I wanted to do and to compose and to create songs like I wanted. And I always wanted to do with a big orchestra songs, and I'm a tap dancer. That's why I love swing and jazz, and that's why my husband, that was my wedding gift from him. And
And you are running a dance school too, right?
Yes, I have a very, very small dance school. It's 25 meters. It's really small. And I have 5 students on each class, and I have 7 classes, because we live in a small village here in Switzerland at the lake, and there is no dancing school. And that's why the mothers were very glad that I make a school here.
Are you in contact with Egon Egemann today?
If I see him on a show or something, then I go to him and we say hello. But it's not that I call him every week. No.
I know you tried to represent Switzerland again as a composer in 2014 with the song Prisoner of Love.
Yes, right. For
how did that come about?
Yes, I knew that Damian, Channing always wanted to go there, and he was a big fan from the Eurovision Song Contest. And so I called him and said, well, listen, what do you think? I have a song for you. Listen to it. Do you like it? And he was very spontaneous, and he did in 3 days, he did the whole song recording and the video. And I like the video very much. I think he did a good job, because he's not a singer. He works on a radio, in fact. And that's why I think he did a really good job.
You're a prisoner, my prisoner of love. When will you be free and lock my heart again? You're a prisoner.
And from what I've heard, is the song about love between two men.
Yes.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Great, Gunvor. I love your support from the LGBT community.
Yes.
Yeah.
But I sang it also, and in my version, it was a man who he took drugs, and he always fell back, and his wife and children had always to visit him in prison. That's why the Prisoner of Love.
You're a prisoner, my prisoner of love. when will you be free and lock my heart again? You're my prisoner of love.
But he did the version for the homosexuals, that's right.
This week's broadcaster decided to have a national final with six songs, where the winner was Sebalta and the song Hunter of Stars, which later gave Switzerland a 13th place in Copenhagen 2014. Mm-hmm. Your song wasn't selected to compete at all in this pre-selection. Mm-hmm. Do you have any theories as to why?
No, I don't know. No, I don't know. No. But I think the song of Sebalta is really great. It's a good song.
I think I'm lying, no. Open the door, cause tonight I cannot go. I'm too for stars, no, no, want me to go. Cause you think I'm lying, cause you think I'm lying, no. Open the door, cause tonight I cannot go. I'm too for stars, no, no.
Have you tried again?
No, I didn't. But if they would ask me, I would say yes.
What would you like to sing or compose?
Well, I think something more modern, because it was a little bit old school, and it has to be some dance stuff. Maybe I have now the song, but it's already out, so I can't take this song anymore. But yeah, something fast, danceable, fresh English, because I was not allowed to sing in German, in English. In 20 years ago, you had to sing in your country language, and yeah, that's now so better if you can sing in English. I mean, everyone can understand what you're singing, and so I would take something fresh, like Lady Gaga or something. Yeah.
But let's say that you could send a song for of those you already have released. Which song would you pick?
Well, it's called Dance, Dance, Dance. I think that's a fresh song.
Dance, 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 if you wanna feel higher. Move, 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 turn up to feel the fire. Dance, 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 if you wanna feel higher.
Or if I would choose a ballad, then I would choose the ballad from Toby Gad. It's called You Killed My Innocence, and it's from my album Gunvor 001, a tribute to James Bond. Those two I would choose.
And now you keep calling, pretending it's okay. Is there nothing you want to say? The way you treat people with courage. You killed the innocence in me.
Yeah, it's great. I mean, the people know me and still book me. That's great. And they listen to my music. My songs are on radio. Yeah, what do you want more?
Going through your discography, I see that you have released songs in French, German, English and Italian.
Yes.
And I know that Switzerland is a multi-language country, but how many languages do you speak?
Well, those four languages I speak, yes.
Oof.
I can't write in Italian, but I speak. Because my grandmother came from Parma, and that's why I speak Italian. And French and English you learn in school.
I'm impressed.
Moi, je ne fais un amour. Une fois, deux fois, c'est comme ça. Je ne fais un amour toujours. Au matin, tous les soirs, avec toi. Moi, je ne fais un amour. Y'a mes filles de party.
Oh,
can you tell me about your new music?
Yes, we did a new collaboration with Jens Gard. It's called the Gunvor Dance School, the album, and I did the lyrics. And we wanted to have 9 songs who are danceable and 1 song, a ballad, for gymnastic rules, I say. And the 9 songs, they will get all choreographies from a choreographer in Spain. He's called Sean Stevens, and I do the videos afterwards. And now I just finished the 3rd video. It's called Little Prayer, and it's a homage to Switzerland somehow. It said in the text, it says, "Motherland, what would I be without you, Switzerland? You always there, you always care."
Would you like to compete in Eurovision again?
Yes, definitely. Yes.
As a composer, artist, or both?
Both.
Okay. I cross my fingers. I think you need a revenge.
Yes, I think so. Lisasia tried again, I think 50 years later or 60 years later.
Yes, she tried twice in the Swiss pre-selection.
So I have a lot of time.
Yes, definitely. Maybe you can write to Ralf Siegel and he will help you.
Yes, I should, maybe. Yeah, that's true.
I always ask my guests who they think I shall invite to the podcast. Who do you suggest?
Well, we were talking a lot about Egon Egemann. Yeah. What do you think?
I would love to talk to Egon. Great suggestion. Thank you so much for this nice conversation, Gunvor.
Yes, thank you. It was a pleasure. Thank you for your time.
I hope to meet you in person next time in Switzerland.
Yes, or maybe we are going to Göteborg one day. So.
Oh, lovely, call me then.
I will let you know.
Perfect.
Okay.
Can't you come to Sweden and perform?
Well, I would love to come to Sweden and perform on an open air or on a concert on stage as a pre-band or for the main act. That would be lovely. I would love to do that. Could you organize that, maybe?
I will do my best and send you some contacts.
That would be great.
And thanks to you, my dear listeners around the world. Don't hesitate to contact me on our social medias at Facebook and Instagram, or the old-fashioned way, emil@schlagervannarna.se. I hope you enjoyed this episode with me and Gunvor. And if you did, subscribe to the podcast, write a review, and tell your friends and enemies about Eurovision legends. Vielen Dank und tschüss.
Thank you. Yeah, you too. And talk to you soon.
Bye.
Bye, Emin. Take care. Ciao.